Hi friends, MD Vegan for the new pea soup. One of my favorite soups. Once in a while I want a pea soup. Peas are wonderful. Legumes, peas, lentils, beans, all these, they are really among the healthiest foods at all. And sweet peas are the easiest way to make it. Yeah, I have these sweet peas, they have been thawed. And fresh, they're more expensive, but I like the thawed ones. They're inexpensive, always available, have a nice sweet flavor. I blend them up, that's it. And the pea soup, the 5 minute pea soup, I make it with different ingredients. This is a pretty simple one. I have the peas here, 2 cups. You can thaw them a little bit. You can run some hot water over them, yeah, through a sieve or so. You can also put it frozen in there. It's not really a problem because I need some liquid here to make it a soup. And today I have coconut milk. And when you have the liquid, it can blend a little bit longer. It's frozen, no problem. Yeah. Only problem if you freeze it without, if it's frozen without water, without liquid, then the blender can get stuck because it's frozen and there is no water. And before it warms up, it takes too much time and the blender is stuck there maybe. So frozen is always good if you have some liquid around it. Enough liquid, then you can also blend frozen. And the coconut milk is easy to make. You can buy it also. You want to make it, there are 2 videos under this video. You can watch that too. So it's easy. And I need a cup only, a cup of coconut milk to begin with. Or let's say, what I usually do is a very simple thing. You know, I use as much liquid so that it is maybe a little bit more water, maybe some more water, maybe it's too thick. Sometimes the coconut milk is too thick, it's some water, so it has to combine everything. See, and if you have it sitting on top of the coconut, here's the water, and it is pretty much as much coconut milk as peas, at least in the blender. To give you a ratio, a similar ratio, about ratio. And that should work. I will try now. I'll put some onion in there. That's what, just a wedge. Yeah, onion powder would also be nice. Add some salt, Himalayan salt, or some teaspoon, yeah, not too much. And some chili powder. Chili powder is nice with peas. Yeah, peas and chili powder, it's a perfect combination. So I try that today, and a little onion. Onion is really, I to put onions and peas together. They are perfect together also. Yeah, even more than chili, I would say. The onion is really close to the pea to me. It has this sweetness, it's hidden, and that is, makes it relating to the pea. And the hot flavor of the onion also, the pea is so soft and gentle and warming, and the hot, sharp flavor from the onion, it's balanced so nicely with the pea, so it's a perfect combination. So very simple today. I have just the peas, the coconut milk, some more water to make it runnier, a zwetch of onion, and Himalayan salt and chili powder. Let's see if that works. Blender dance. Yeah, it is a little bit too thick. You see, it could be a little bit runnier. The texture is always important for a soup. Some people like soup a little bit thicker. I like it a little bit runnier. Basically up to you, but that's why I put some more water. But as I put some more water, I might have to use some more seasoning. I will decide that later. Now, one more blender dance to get it runny. I like a piece of a little bit warm also, no problem. You blend a little bit longer. Also coconut milk, if it, sometimes the coconut milk, you leave it in the refrigerator and it sits, the coconut cream sits on top of the milk and the water is down. And you have this block of coconut cream and you blend it, it needs some more blending because that can't, until it really gets into milk again, you need some more blending to really mix it up. Also, if you want to make it in your own blender, you might have to blend a little bit longer to get really creamy because of the coconut milk, it can be a little bit lumpy. But now the texture is really nice. It's a good, nice texture of the soup. I'll show you in a moment. First, I taste it and I see might have to use some more water, salt and chili because of the water. Let's see. The flavor is divine. No more chili. It's a wonderful chili flavor there. And salt. Ha! It's tricky. I do taste some salt. I do taste some salt. You know what? I say no. Enough salt. In the end, after all, it wasn't that much water. Just a little bit. And I'll show you what the soup looks like here. Isn't that beautiful? That's the perfect texture. And as I said, you can blend a little bit longer to get a warm soup. And then you have this wonderful coconut pea soup, chili coconut pea soup, I should say. To get it round, I don't count the onion in the title. Onion is always in the pea soup, I mean, so I don't even mention. So, you can make it warm. That is very nice. Can be with pea soup, really, really nice. And what also could do, you could cut some avocados, yeah, and decorate the soup with it. I don't know if I do that now, but it's always nice to have this. Yeah. And maybe sprinkle some salt on top of the avocado, these kind of things, make it nicer to decorate for the eyes. That's up to you. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. Try my other pea soup recipes. Yeah, it's one of my great recipes. I am very proud of it. Yeah, and so many variations. Yeah, and this is a new one. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. If you like my video, subscribe MDV on YouTube. Have another recipe every single day. And find me on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and Twitter.